On behalf of Mendio GK and parent company PrepQ, I, Manish Kane, welcome you to this session on current affairs. In these sessions on current affairs, in our daily sessions that is, we discuss exam-oriented questions of current affairs, such questions which might be appear in one of the government exams or which might appear in one of the MBA entrance exams. Government exams like IBPS PO or LIC insurance or RRB, that is Railway Recruitment Board, etc. And MBA entrance like TISNET, conducted by the Tata Institute of Social Sciences, SNAP, conducted by the Symbiosis University, and so on. So if you're appearing for any of these examinations, just stay with us for 10-15 minutes every day and you will be adequately prepared for current affairs. Let's move to the first question. The date today is 19th April 2019. And the first question is, recently Google and Apple have removed which social media app from Play Store and App Store following directions of the Ministry of Electronics and Information Technology? Sahi answer hai TikTok. Ye question humne kal bhi discuss kiya tha aur aapko yaad hoga ki TikTok ek Chinese company hai ByteDance naam ki, जिसने TikTok वीडियोस को का ऐप जो है वो डेवलप किया है और इसके 800 मिलियन से ज़्यादा डाउनलोड्स हो गए थे और अभी एक मद्रास हाई कोर्ट के ऑर्डर के बाद इन वीडियोस को, इस ऐप को गूगल प्ले स्टोर ने भी और एप्पल प्ले स्टोर ने भी रिमूव कर दिया है, निकाल दिया है. नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन, विच ऑफ द फॉलोइंग रेलवे स्टेशन क्लेम्स वर्ल्ड्स लॉन्गेस्ट रेलवे स्टेशन नेम टाइटल? इसका सही जवाब है, ये प्रोनाउंस करना इज वेरी डिफिकल्ट, सो ललन फेयर ट्वल रेलवे स्टेशन. इंडिया हैज इट्स शेयर ऑफ लार्ज और बिग स्टेशन नेम्स बट नथिंग कैन बीट द स्टेशन नेम. नाउ यू कैन एक्चुअली सी दैट दिस इज वन वर्ड, दिस इज द नेम ऑफ द स्टेशंस एंड देयर इज नो वे आई कैन और आई विल ट्राई टू प्रोनाउंस इट, बट दिस नेम इज अ 58 कैरेक्टर word for a station name in Wales, England, and this is the longest station name in the world. And this was in news recently because a Madras station was renamed, the Chennai Central station was renamed as Porachi Thalaivar Dr. M.G. Ramachandran Central Railway Station, and this happens to be the second biggest name for a railway station in the world. It is only one character less, that is 57 characters, one less than the railway station which happens to be the largest name for a railway station in the world. The some of the other large railway station names in India are Krantivir Sangoli Rayanna Bangalore City Railway Station. Then you have Venkata Narasimha Raju Varipeta in Andhra Pradesh. Now these are pretty long station names. Even Maharaja Chhatrapati Shivaji Terminus, this also qualifies to be a very long station name. So far, you know, that is for long station names. Next question, which country has disarmed its police as terror level threat level lowered this year? The correct answer is New Zealand. And so police has been disarmed because the terror threat level had reduced from high to medium. And we did discuss New Zealand a few days back. You would remember that Prime Minister of New Zealand is Jacinda Ardern. And after the Christchurch attack in March this year, in 2019, the threat level perception was increased to high. So now it has reduced. The capital of New Zealand is Wellington. And the currency which is in use in New Zealand is dollar. Next question. ICC partners with UNICEF to organize a tournament for kids at 2019 World Cup named as? The correct answer is One Day for Children. So this hash One Day for Children is an initiative to help build a better world for kids. So this particular campaign will be run during the World Cup, which is supposed to be played in the next 2 months in this year. And this campaign will bring UNICEF and ICC as partners, and they will run this campaign and collect money through this campaign during the World Cup. And the ambassador, Nasir Hussain and Chris Wokes, both of them are England players. And Nasir Hussain was an ex-England player. So they launched this campaign, and the money raised will help UNICEF's work in cricket-playing nations. So UNICEF works for children's education, and this money raised will help in their work in cricket-playing nations specifically. Next question. Where did the 8th edition of Home Expo India 2019 start? And the correct answer here is Greater Noida. So this was the 8th edition of the Home Expo by EPCH. So this EPCH means Export Promotion Council for Handicrafts. It started on 16th April, and the focus areas this year were home decor, furnishings, furniture, flooring and textiles. 500 companies exhibited their products, and roughly 50 member countries are expected to visit the Home Expo. Next question. On which day is the Himachal Day celebrated? The correct answer is 15th April. So 15th April is the foundation day for Himachal Pradesh. So it is the 72nd day, Himachal Pradesh Day. And in the remembrance of its creation, this day is celebrated, observed as Himachal Day. So earlier, Himachal Pradesh was a part of Punjab province during the British rule. And after the British rule, when Indian governance started, Himachal Pradesh was separated from Punjab's control. The name Himachal Pradesh incidentally was given by Acharya Divakar Dutt Sharma, who was an eminent Sanskrit scholar from Himachal Pradesh. And Sanskrit happens to be the official language, one of the official languages of Himachal Pradesh apart from Hindi. Incidentally, Sanskrit is the official language of two states in India. One is Uttarakhand and the other is Himachal Pradesh. You can keep this thing in mind. Remember, Sanskrit was named as the official language. This year only in February, a bill to introduce Sanskrit as an official language was introduced in the Legislative Assembly of Himachal Pradesh by the Chief Minister Jairam Thakur. Next, recently, which bank has opened paperless account facility for NRIs? The correct answer is IDBI Bank. So, what is the name? The name of this facility is NRI Insta Online Account, and this facility will be given to NRIs residing in FATF countries. FATF is also known as Groupe d'Action Financière in French. FATF stands for Financial Action Task Force Countries. Now, what are these Financial Action Task Force or FATF countries? So this is a group of countries which have come together to prevent the money laundering that was happening for illegal use of money to fund criminal activities. So there are many countries who have come together to prevent this money laundering, especially in the wake of money being laundered into criminal and terrorist activities. So the headquarter of the FATF is Paris, and the current president of FATF organization is Marshall Billingsley. Now, what is money laundering? Now, money laundering is a process. It's a mechanism by which money earned illegally is converted into white money. In very simple terms, black money converted into white money by some mechanism. So this is money laundering. And the name money laundering, it comes from the process being used by the Italian mafia, Al Capone. So what the Italian mafia did was, they used to raise money from extortion, from kidnappings, from drugs. And to convert this black money into white money, they bought laundromats. And these laundromats, the income from illegal activities was shown as income from laundromats. And that is how they were able to launder money. And hence the term money laundering. So once again, money laundering is the conversion of black money to white money by some mechanism. In India, money laundering also refers to hawala dealings. Next question. Which bank appointed Rajesh Yaduvanshi as executive director? So correct answer is Punjab National Bank. So there were two other executive directors to Punjab National Bank. The names are L.V. Prabhakar and A.K. Azad. Next question. Who is recently appointed as brand ambassador of the bus ticketing platform Red Bus? The correct answer is Mahendra Singh Dhoni. So he has recently been appointed as the brand ambassador. Red Bus, as all of you know, is a ticketing, very popular ticketing platform, in fact, which started operations in August 2006. And people who were founders of Red Bus are Fanindra Sama, Sudhakar Pasupunari, and Charan Padmaraju. These three people were founders of the Red Bus ticketing platform. It was acquired by IBO, which is the parent organization of Red Bus now. And IBBO, in turn, the parent organization of IBBO is MMT, which means Make My Trip. Next question. Recently, which American singer was posthumously awarded Pulitzer Prize? The correct answer is Aretha Franklin. She is also referred to as Queen of Soul. She was given the Pulitzer for her contribution to American music and culture. She is also the first woman to have been awarded this prize. That brings us to the last part of our session. Question of the day. The first question is, which player launched the hash one day for children campaigns? So you have to name all the players. And second question, what is the meaning of the term money laundering? You have to answer, you have to key in your answers in the comment section given below. If you're liking our sessions, please do not forget to share these sessions with among your friends, among your study groups, among your WhatsApp groups. And if you have any feedback or queries, please feel free to write to us, to message me on the number that I provide every day, or you can just simply put your comments in the comment section. If you're looking for CAT preparation, then you can log on to myprepq.com, and there are three courses available on this website which you can acquire from this website. If you're looking at free resources, then Mend Your Maths, Mend Your Reasoning, and Mend Your GK.com are three free resources for any aptitude test preparation. For career guidance, you can contact me on this number. With this, we come to an end of today's GK session. Thank you very much.